and the technology related open source university. In these 5 minutes, I would like to tell you more about the open source university project and what we're building. But I would like to start with a quote of a very intelligent person who says that the illiterate of the 21st century are not going to be the ones who cannot read and write, but those who cannot learn, unlearn, and relearn. So that's one of the first problems we're solving. But let's highlight some of the other problems on the current market. First of all, it's the dispersion of content. Content is distributed to so many places, and there are more than 7,000 MOOC platforms out there. Strength existing model that was designed thousands of years ago and is no longer working. Trust and transparency. How do we verify the credentials of people? And the huge gap between businesses and education. People who are graduating are not matching always the business needs. We solve this by creating a digital credentials passport on the blockchain, so that people could easily store all their achievements and showcase them to the businesses and people they are working with, by providing a global catalog of online courses that provide blockchain certification, and by providing more flexibility and modularity to the educational content platforms. Our platform is simple to understand. Academia is issuing certificates on the blockchain. We store them into the credential passport of people. And based on this credential passport, we enhance better communication between people and businesses. This way we provide trust. In addition to that, businesses have the option to provide more feedback to the academia about what type of people they are looking to recruit and improve the overall direction of the business and enhances better competitiveness. The distributed ledger technologies that we utilize are blockchain, which provides trust and transparency, smart contracts, which provide automation of value transfer, distributed storage, which is IPFS, where we can upload people certificate in a very immutable way, and a cryptocurrency for our tokenized marketplace. So the cryptocurrency that we're issuing is called EDU tokens, and we sell that on an ICO campaign. In terms of privacy, we use cryptographic approaches in order to make sure that learners' private data is protected and that they are in control with whom they share that information and how that happens. Some of our partners are leading businesses in the HR industry, in the academia world. You can check all that information on our website, which is os.university. The project has global recognition. Recently, we were invited to the Educate London EdTech Incubator, which is leading in its industry. Again, information that is visible on our website. Those people which you see on the screen are people who at one point in their life decided to provide fake certificates, and they actually made it to a C-level position. The current state of the platform is that it's open source and developed on GitHub. Feel free to check it out. We're about to release the alpha very soon. For the funding model, we use an ICO campaign because we believe this is a great way to crowdfund your project in the modern world. It's a small but yet very important aspect of our project. Why do we need the token though? Because this allows us to tokenize the educational content marketplace. It's a very good incentive for learners to continue their studies and to get certificates. Our token is limited to 48 million and our ICO is currently ongoing. We have 4 more days to go. We are also going to accept fiat money in order to increase the adoption of the platform. In that case, we charge 5% commission and we use that commission to buy off tokens from the exchange and to burn them. Buy the tokens on the website. The procedure is very simple. Send Ether to the crowdsell smart contract and pass the KYC procedure. The team is part of Verb has some very well-renowned people like the former Minister of Education. Again, check that on the website. We were nominated for most innovative use of blockchain for social good, and the ceremony was yesterday. We also have the Doctoral Research Award for the year of 2017. We were also nominated as top 3 young entrepreneurs by the Bulgarian Association of Information Technologies. So let's keep in touch until stand number 47.